एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द अप्रोक्सीमेशंस। नाउ अप्रोक्सीमेशन इज वन ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द डेरिवेटिव्स। नाउ एज पर द नेम सजेस्ट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड द अप्रोक्सीमेट वैल्यूज ऑफ द फंक्शंस। ओके, नाउ दिस कैन बी डन बाय यूजिंग द डेरिवेटिव्स। ओके, सो लेट अस जस्ट स्टार्ट विद द वीडियो। नाउ सपोज इफ आई टेल यू टू फाइंड द स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 36, so you will say that it is nothing but 6. Okay, but if I tell you that what is the square root of 27, okay, now you will say that it will be greater than 6 but less than 7. It can be 6.2, 6.3 or 6.5. that is your approximation, right? Now if I tell you that what is the cube root of 27, okay, so this is nothing but 3. Okay, so cube root of 27 is nothing but 3. But if I tell you what is the cube root of 28, okay, now this will be, the value will be greater than 3. Okay, it may be 3.2 or 3.3. that will be the approximation that you will consider. Okay, so similar manner we are going to find out the values of this kinds of expressions by using the approximations. So for this we have a formula in the derivatives, that is nothing but f of a plus h approximately equal to f of a plus h into f dash of a. Okay, so this is the main formula that are going to use for finding the approximations. Okay, now let us understand the formula. So here the formula is quite simple. You just have to split your numbers in a and h, okay, and then you have to take the function of f of a, then h multiplied by its derivative of f of a. Okay, that is f dash of a. Now you will understand this with the help of the simple example that I am going to solve now. So the first question here, it says cube root of 28. We have to find out the value of cube root of 28. Okay, so whenever you start with the problem, you have to identify the function. Okay, now you can see that this is nothing but the cube root of 28. So here you can take 28 as a function. Okay, so this can be considered as x to the power 1 by 3. Cube root is nothing but 1 by 3. Okay, so I can say that here the function is nothing but x to the power 1 by 3. Okay, got it now? Okay, now what you can do further is to find the derivative, because according to the formula we have this. Now we have to find the derivative. Okay, so the derivative of the function will be, power will come here and it will get subtracted by 1. Okay, so this will give you 1 by 3 x to the power minus 2 by 3. Okay, now we have got this. Now let us just split 28, because we have to split the 28 into different terms. Okay, so you know that x is nothing but 28. Okay, now we have to split the 28 into its nearest possible value. Okay, that can satisfy this equation. So what is that value which will satisfy this cube root, which is nothing but 27. Okay, so the cube root of 27 is possible, because cube root of 27 is 3, but cube root of 28 is not possible. Okay, so we are going to split the 28 as 27 plus 1. Okay, so this is the value which will going to satisfy this function. So 27 is nothing but a and 1 is nothing but h. Okay, so a is 27, h is 1 here. Okay, now so I will write a is equal to 27 and h is equal to 1. Okay, now according to the formula we have to find the f of a. So f of x we have. Okay, so we are going to substitute here. F of a is equal to 27 raised to power 1 by 3. Okay, which is nothing but 3, right? Now you know that f dash of a is already been carried out here, which is 1 by 3 x to the power minus 2 by 3. So f dash of a will be 1 by 3 27 to the power minus 2 by 3. Now we are going to calculate this. This is very simple. We just have to focus here. So this can be written as 1 by 3, 1 upon cube root of 27, and it is square. Okay. So this can be 1 by 3, cube root of 27 is 3, and 3 square is nothing but 9. Okay. So this is nothing but 27. So f dash of a is nothing but 1 upon 27. So we have got it now. So for finding the approximate value, we have got f of a, f dash of a, and we already know h as 1. Okay. So we are going to use the formula. Okay. So I'll write the formula, which is nothing but f of a plus h approximately equal to f of a plus h into f dash of a. This will be approximately equal to f of a is nothing but 3 plus h is nothing but 1 upon 27. So this is the value. So when you solve this, 27 into 3, then plus 1 upon 27. Okay. That will give you 82 upon 27. Okay. When you divide this, you will get approximately equal to 3.037. Okay. Now, what is f of a plus h? Now, this is very simple. F of h, a plus h is nothing but 28. Okay. And the function that we have taken here, which is nothing but cube root of 28. Okay. So basically, this is nothing but cube root of 28, which is approximately equal to 3.037. Okay. So this is quite simple. And we are going to solve some more problems, which will clear your doubts. Okay. Now the second question here, it says we have to find the value of sine 61 degree, given that 1 degree is equal to 0.0174 radian and root 3 is equal to 1.732. So we have to find the value of sine 61. Now you know that in the trigonometric ratio, we know the value of sine 60 degree. Okay. Now sine 60 degree is nothing but root 3 by 2. But we don't know the value of sine 61. So clearly here the function is nothing but sine. Okay. And we have to take this number as x. Okay. So here the function becomes sine x. Okay. So the function here is sine x. Now first we have to find the derivative of the function. So the derivative of sine x is nothing but cos x. Okay. Now after we have found out the derivative, we are going to split the 61. Okay. Because the nearest value that will give you, or you know the value of sine, is nothing but 60. Okay. So here x is equal to 61 degree, which can be splitted as 60 degree plus 1 degree. Okay. And this can be considered as a plus h. Okay. So basically a is nothing but 60 degree and h is nothing but 1 degree. But we know that 1 degree is equal to 0.0174. Okay. Now we have done with this. Now we are going to find our value of f of a and f dash of a. So we have got f of x. So f of a will be sine of 60 degree, which is root 3 by 2. Now we know the value of root 3, which is 1.732 upon 2. Okay. That will give you the value of 0.866. Then the next value is f dash of a. So f dash of a is nothing but cos x and cos 60. So cos 60 is nothing but 1 by 2, which is 0.5. Okay. Now, after finding both the values, we are going to use the formula. The formula of approximation, which is f of a plus h approximately equal to f of a plus h times f dash of a. Okay. Now f of a is nothing but 0.866 plus h. H is nothing but 0.0174 into f dash of a is nothing but 0.5. Okay. So when you solve this, you will get 0.866 plus 0.0087. So when you add this, you will get 0.8747. ओके, नाउ एफ ऑफ ए प्लस एच इज नथिंग बट साइन 61 डिग्री. ओके, सो बेसिकली द अप्रोक्सीमेट वैल्यू ऑफ साइन 61 डिग्री इज नथिंग बट 0.8747. नाउ द एग्जैक्ट वैल्यू ऑफ साइन 60 डिग्री इज 0.866. सो यू कैन सी दैट देर इज अ स्मॉल डिफरेंस बिटवीन 0.866 एंड 0.8747. ओके, सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस प्रॉब्लम. Now let us move on to the next question. So the next question here, it says find the approximate value of cot inverse of 0.999. Okay, now we know that cot inverse of 1 is nothing but pi by 4 radian. That means at pi by 4 the value of cot is nothing but 1. Okay, so this value is just small than 1. Okay, so basically clearly this function here is nothing but cot inverse function. Okay, that is inverse trigonometric function. So here you can see that the function here can be considered as cot inverse of x. Okay, now since we have got the function, now let us just derivate this. So the derivation of cot inverse x, that is the derivative of cot inverse x, is nothing but minus 1 upon 1 plus x square. Okay, now after finding the derivative, let us take the value that we have got, which is 0.999. Now you know that this can be written as 1 minus 0.001. Okay, so 1 minus 0.001, that will give you 0.999, and this can be considered as a plus h. So basically here we have got a is equal to 1 and h is equal to minus 0.001. okay, this will be minus. Okay, now after getting the value of a and h, we are going to find out the value of f of a and f dash of a. So f of a, so we have got the function, so this will be cot inverse of 1. This is nothing but pi by 4 radian. Okay, then after this, f dash of a, which is minus 1 upon 1 plus 1 square, that will give you minus 1 upon 1 plus 1, that will be nothing but 2. Okay, which is minus 0.5. Now after getting the value of f of a and f dash of a, we are going to use the formula of approximation, which is given by f of a plus h approximately equal to f of a plus h times f dash of a. Okay, substituting the value of this, so this will be pi by 4. Now here you know the value of pi is nothing but 3.14 upon 4. Okay, so you can divide this and get the value, which is nothing but 0.7854. okay, so 0.7854, so I'll substitute here. This will give you 0.7854 plus h. So h here is nothing but minus 0.001 multiplied by minus 0.5. Okay, so this minus minus will make it plus, and this will be 0.005, and that will be approximately equal to 0.7859. And this is nothing but the approximate value of cot inverse of 0.9999. Okay, so we have got the value, which is nothing but cot inverse of 0.999 approximately equal to 0.7859. Okay, now that was quite simple. You just have to identify the right function and derivate this and use the formula of approximation. Now let us solve one more question based on this. Okay, the next question here, it says find the approximate value of log of 101 to the base e, given that log of 10 to the base e is equal to 2.3026. Okay, now from the question itself, you can see that the function here is clearly a log function. Okay, so here f of x will be log of x to the base e. Okay, then we have got the function, let us find the derivative. So the derivative of log of function is nothing but 1 upon x. Okay, now we have taken x as 101, so let us split 101. Now how can you split 101? Okay, so that is very simple. You know that 101 can be written as 100 plus 1. Now why I have written 100 plus 1? Because log of 100, that will give you 2 log of 10, and we have got the value of log 10. Okay, so that's why I've written 100 plus 1, which is a plus h. Okay, so here a is nothing but 100 and h is nothing but 1. Okay, now after doing this, let us find the value of f of a. So this will be log of 100 to the base e, and further it can be written as 10 to the power 2. And due to the property of log, this can be written as 2 log of 10 to the base e. Okay, and the value of this is already given, which is 2 times 2.3026. Okay, that will give you 4.6052. Okay, so this is f of a. Okay, now we are going to find the value of f dash of x. So this is f dash of a, which is 1 upon 100. Okay, that will give you 0.01. Now, after finding this, we are going to use the approximation formula, which is f of a plus h approximately equal to f of a plus h times f dash of a. Okay, now f of a is nothing but 4.6052 plus h is nothing but 1 times 0.01. And after doing this, you can get the answer as 4.6152. So this is the value of log of 101 to the base e. Okay, so for this kind of function, you have to solve like this. You have to see that what is given in the question, and according to that, you have to break the value. Okay, so I hope you have understood the topic approximation. If you have got any doubt, do let me know in the comments. Also, subscribe to my channel and share it with friends. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video.